Hi, I am Valder Beebe. I am the host and the visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
Good day, Dr. Doug Casa. Thank you for joining me live here in Dallas, Texas, as I broadcast across the nation on an FM platform. I want to talk about a great topic today, safety in the heat. Well, a lot of people can relate to that. From California to Texas, what do you have for us?
So how are you today? I heard it's going to be pretty hot day in Dallas today, huh?
Oh, it's just regular hot here. So we worry about people in other places.
Yes.
I think it'll be 100, close to 100, but that's average for us.
Yes, that's true. Yeah, so obviously it's August 1st, right? So football teams and your high school sports teams are about to get ready to go or starting practices, conditioning sessions, and so we just wanted to share some tips about exercising safely in the heat.
Sounds good. Now we got runners and walkers. We got to include them also, too. But what information can we give our exercise enthusiasts?
All right. Well, the biggest things, you know, from a parent perspective with their athletes heading out to practices would be to making sure that they're hydrated before they head out to the practice session, and making sure that their coaches are encouraging hydration breaks, and during more intense exercise, during hotter conditions, they're having more rest breaks and longer rest breaks. And the athletes themselves making sure that they're hydrating more during meals, before, during, and after meals, and then checking their urine color through the day, so that if their urine is light like lemonade, they're probably hydrated. If it's dark like apple juice, they probably need some more fluid, and they should heed that advice. If they're ever thirsty during the day, use that as an important cue that they need to drink. During a practice session, don't ever hesitate to drink fluids when they feel they need them and they're thirsty. Coaches need to allow athletes access to fluids, either when they need it themselves, but also encouraging fluid during breaks. An athlete's going to have a higher quality exercise session if they are properly hydrated. So those are all some of the things that we encourage people to consider. Athletes themselves, you know, like if you're talking about just runners or recreational athletes who are out during these hot conditions, we would always encourage people to try to go during the cooler times of the day when possible. If it's really hot, to not go as hard, change the intensity if they're not feeling well, and really listen to their body. If it's a particular day that they're coming back from an illness or they're sick or they're just not feeling well, something's not going right, to just heed that advice and save the great effort for another day. Because usually when there's a problem in the heat, when someone has a heat stroke, it's usually due to some particular issue, like someone's coming back from an illness or an injury, or it's their first day of practice, or they're just ramping up their exercise, or it's hotter than usual. So just making modifications when necessary can be really, you know, smart advice when people are out in the heat.
I want my audience to know that Dr. Doug Casa is a heat stroke expert with more than 30 years' experience of research. Dr. Casa, have you had a personal interaction with stroke?
Yeah, so when I was 16 years old, running in a 10K race on the track at the Empire State Games, which is a state championship meet in New York State, that 10K race is a 25-lap race on the track, which on the very final lap of that race, I collapsed, and I got back up, ran a little bit more, and then collapsed again just before the finish line, and then I was in a coma for the remainder of the afternoon, having suffered an exertional heat stroke. But that was an important lesson to be learned from that day, because they had the 10K scheduled for noontime during the middle of the summer. It was August 8th, and a 25-lap race, you should not be scheduling for the middle of the day. I mean, that's something you would do in the morning or in the evening. And also, they didn't allow hydration during the race, and there were other factors that adult supervisors could have implemented to make it safer. But obviously it's that experience that galvanized my interest in trying to, you know, prevent that from happening to other people.
I hear your passion about it, and I love someone who brings passion to what they are actually telling the rest of us. Those people that are listening to you, if they're online, where they can go and get more information.
Sure, yeah. I mean, I work at the Corey Stringer Institute at the University of Connecticut. Corey Stringer was an NFL player who died from exertional heat stroke, and very ironically, he actually passed away 18 years ago today on August 1st, 2001, and we formed this institute to try to educate people about hydration and safely exercising in the heat, and trying to keep athletes, warfighters, and laborers safe. So the ksi.ucon.edu, and UConn is UConn. That's a great resource that we have for people to try to learn more about safely exercising in the heat.
I want to thank you so very much for sharing your personal testimony and sharing your professional medical expertise. We really appreciate that, Dr. Casa. Thanks for being my guest on the Valder Beebe Show.
Oh, it's an honor to be here. Thank you so much for having me. Have a great day.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.